All right, so I just got back from seeing Logan. Like, literally, I just walked out the theater. I'm back in my car. So this is going to be a spoiler-free review right now, but at the end of this video, I'm going to talk about spoilers. If you haven't seen the movie, go see it. I mean, you can listen to this review, obviously, or watch this review having not seen it. But the later half of this video, when I talk about spoilers, I'll let you guys know when I'm going to talk about spoilers. Do not watch unless you've seen the movie. Like, trust me, you do not want this ruined. I'm gonna say right off the bat, this movie is a 10 out of 10. Like, oh my God, it was so good. Like, I literally cannot think of any problems I had. Like, maybe like one or two minor things, which I'll talk about actually kind of in the spoilers, because they are kind of spoilers. Wow, this movie was it was incredible. Like, I'm like shocked like at what I just saw. Like, it was so well done. And I love that it was rated R. Wow, man. And oh, by the way, actually no, I'll say it in spoilers. Yeah, I'll say it in spoilers, never mind. If you're wondering what the heck I'm talking about, I'll mention what I'm talking about later. If you've seen the movie, you're like, wait, what's he about to say? Anyways, it's not, I'm rambling on here. Wow, I mean, bloody, violent, F-bombs, fuck this, fuck that, motherfucker. Oh my God. All right, so in terms of action, just 10 out of 10. Action was incredible. All the action scenes were great, all the main, action parts, all the fighting, all the claw fighting with Wolverine and, X-23, just incredible stuff. And X-23 was awesome, the little girl. I believe this is her first movie because when they list the actors' names in the beginning, it said introducing, I believe Daphne Keene is her name. It said introducing Daphne Keene. So I assume this is her first movie, and she did a very good job, like, acting-wise, everything, dialogue, everything. Hugh Jackman, incredible, of course. This is probably, honestly, right now, I want to say this is, I did a ranking of all the X-Men movies, including Deadpool. I put X-Men Days of Future Past as number one. This movie just might be number one now. I mean, wow. I mean, and it's just you just saw it, man. I know. I just saw it, so that's why I'm saying that. But I feel like it really is number one. It's like the most well-crafted movie out of the whole series. It's the most emotional, and a lot. And I actually had this thought in my mind that maybe it wouldn't be funny at all, but there's a lot of funny moments in this movie. Like, there's a lot. I was surprised. But don't get me wrong, I love serious movies, I love drama. And this is not a conventional superhero movie. I mean, there is action, of course, there are, several, mutants in the movie. Wow, it's unlike, all the other, ensemble movies and team movies and all that stuff. Blockbuster movies. I mean, this is, it is a superhero film, but it's very much like a Western, it's very much like a drama. It's just wow. James Mangold, great director. He did The Wolverine, which was miles better than X-Men Origins. Oh God. You know what? Comparing this movie Logan to X-Men Origins Wolverine is like it's like night and day. Like literally, like oh my God. That movie was so terrible while this one was like a masterpiece. Like honestly, I want to call this a masterpiece. Just it was amazing. I mean, I love the way they handled everything. I felt like the movie got a little, just a little bit slow, kind of during like the last, well, not the last half. Well, kind of like in the last half. Like, okay, let's divide the movie in like fourths. Three fourths of the way, it kind of got slow, if that makes any sense. Three quarters of the way. I could divide it by Act One, Act Two, Act Three, but I couldn't really tell where in which it, well, I could tell where the acts began, but I would say like three quarters through the movie, it kind of got a little slow. If you've seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. But after that, it picks up. I mean, don't worry, this movie is entertaining throughout. It's awesome. See, I just do off the cuff reviews. I don't script them or anything. I just go on. Just incredible, man. I'm definitely gonna go see this again, probably. I'm definitely buying it when it comes out. That's a damn for damn sure. And if Hugh Jackman, he says this is his last performance. Also, Patrick Stewart said this is gonna be his last time playing Professor X. I mean, this movie, perfect ending for them. If this is their last appearances, this is the perfect way to finish it. I mean, just incredible. I mean, I've grown up with all the X-Men films. I used to watch the cartoon, but I've been such a huge fan of the movies, and you know, Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, one of the best casting choices ever. Probably my favorite. Honestly, I think Wolverine is my favorite comic book character ever. I mean, I'm not, you know, crazy about the comics in particular, but in terms of, you know, comic book characters, you know, adapted to television and you know, with the animated series and also what I've seen, you know, in the movies, I love Wolverine. I love his story. I love, you know, the whole, you know, adamantium, the healing, losing his memory, you know, all that stuff. And he's, you know, hundreds of years old. He's like 200 years old, right? About, by, you know, in this movie takes place in 2029. And it's interesting too. They like have a lot of, you know, different things in the movie that kind of, you know, don't exist nowadays, of course. There's certain things in there, but, and, you know, I saw, I watched, I think it was Chris Stuckman's review or Jeremy John's. Those are like the two big movie reviewers on YouTube. I watched both the reviews, and one of them, it might've been Chris Stuckman, said they didn't like the villain that much in the movie. You know what? I actually kind of liked him. Like I, you know, he was despicable, but you know, I actually like enjoyed like, you know, his dialogue and his, you know, his personality, I guess, if that makes any sense. I'm talking about the guy with the robotic hand. There's also another guy in there. I mean, I won't talk much about that because they only showed him briefly in like one trailer, I think. He wasn't that interesting. He was just kind of a generic baddie, but the guy with the robotic hand was cool. You know, he was an asshole, but I like the character, I guess, like I said. Man, I don't know what else to talk about. It's just because, you know, I want to talk spoilers, but I'll save that, like I said, in a bit here. What else can I say without spoiling? Like I said, the dynamic with Wolverine, Professor X, and X-23 is incredible. They have a very good chemistry together. And there's a certain thing that they do with Professor X in the movie. Like I said, if you've seen it, you know what I'm talking about. Where he's, you know, he's not well. He's kind of, you know, losing his health. He's very old. He's, you know, losing his powers, kind of. But there's a certain thing they do with it that's so crazy and so unique. It was so interesting to watch. It was like, whoa. Like, you can see it in a few of the trailers. If you look closely at the trailers, there's something that goes wrong with his powers. I'm not going to say, you know, what exactly. Not goes wrong, but, you know, his powers kind of make things crazy. But, yeah, just, I'm serious, like, 10 out of 10, man. This was a 10 out of 10, I think. Incredible. Like, really good. All right, what else can I say? I'm trying to give as much as I can so you guys, without spoiling, so you guys can understand how I feel. Just great. I mean, you know, like I said, this is the 10th movie, I think, and this is Hugh Jackman's ninth time playing Wolverine. 9 times. 17 years. I mean, perfect send-off, honestly. It's just a freaking great movie, man. And yes, if this movie wasn't rated R, I probably wouldn't like it as much, to be honest. They utilize the rated R rating. Honestly, I think they use it more than Deadpool used it. Like, this movie is so much more rated R than Deadpool is, in my opinion. Like, it is so freaking gory and so freaking crazy. Like, I feel like Deadpool might have more curse words in it, maybe. Actually, this movie might rival it. There's a lot of F-bombs. You know, Deadpool was gory, but, you know, not like, all over. Like, I mean, it was gory in a lot of scenes, but, like, not crazy gory, I would say. This movie, freaking crazy gory. Like, crazy gory. Like, this movie felt like a freaking horror movie at times. Yeah, man, incredible. You know, maybe after, like, a repeated viewing, if I see it again, or, you know, give myself some time to think about it more, I might not put this movie at a 10 out of 10, or, you know, number one on the X-Men movie list. But for right now, I'm going to do that, because it was incredible. I'm trying to see if the lighting's good in here. Is it good? Ah, man. Go see the movie. All right. I think that's all I can say. All right, so, like I said, 10 out of 10, if you're wondering what rating I'd give it, A+. So, now I'm going to talk about spoilers. I feel like I'm going to have a lot to say, so if you haven't seen the movie, for the love of God, turn off this video. You can come back if you want after you've seen it, whatever. Do not watch this part if you've not seen the movie, please. I'm telling you, you need to see this movie. All right, so here we go. 1, 2, 3. All right. Okay. All right. So I figured Professor X would die. I wasn't sure if they were going to kill Wolverine, but they did. I feel like, you know, you don't necessarily have to kill him, but if you really do want to send off the character, you know, it, and also he died doing something great. He let the kids go, you know, he saved those kids. It was really sad. It was really emotional. I did cry a little bit. I know I thought I'd cry a little more, but I cried a little bit. You know, all the memories were coming back to my mind of, you know, all the old X-Men movies and, you know, and, you know, I honestly feel like, you know, Professor X's death was kind of a little more emotional for me. It just came out of nowhere and it was so shocking. At first, all right, let's talk about X-24, aka the Wolverine clone. Obviously, it's a much younger, you know, younger Wolverine, you know, like in his prime, I guess you could say. I guess they made a clone out of Wolverine, another clone. Like, you know, I was thinking, like, okay, X-23 Laura is supposed to be a clone of Wolverine, you know, a female, but she's a lot younger. Couldn't they, like, literally clone Wolverine? Like, make another Wolverine, like, identical to him? And they actually did. And I was surprised to see that. But when he showed up, it was like, whoa, what the hell's happening? Like, it kind of just happened out of nowhere. Because, you know, they were in that dude's house where they had the dinner, right? With that guy's family. Professor X was laying in bed talking to Wolverine. You can't really see Wolverine. It's like, sure, it's dark in the room. And he's talking to him. I'm like, oh, okay, this is like a, you know, sad. He's like telling him a story and stuff. And out of nowhere, he freaking stabs him. Like, whoa, what the hell's going on? Is this a nightmare or something? I literally thought it was, like, a nightmare sequence or something. Like, I didn't think Professor X actually got stabbed. I was like, whoa, this must be some nightmare he's having. No, it continues on. And then Laura freaks out. And then they reveal it's a younger Wolverine. I'm like, what the fuck's going on? And, you know, earlier in the movie, they were talking about, oh, they're working on something else. And they, like, kind of briefly showed it in those, you know, tubes and the blue liquid and all that stuff. You could see, like, the arms and the hands. But you couldn't see, who it was, and it was actually another Wolverine, X-24. I was like, yo, that caught me off guard. So Hugh Jackman actually, you know, played a younger, oh, I guess, you know, he tried to look younger. I mean, they made him look really old in this movie, so maybe he didn't have to try that hard to look younger. But he played X-24 also, and he was freaking savage, man. That thing was a fucking killing machine. Like, holy shit. That thing scared me. I was like, holy fuck. But, you know, it's crazy because he killed Professor X, and I was like, oh my god, this is how Professor X is going to die. If you think about it, Professor X has never died technically. I know you could say in The Last Stand he died, but then they had that bullshit, you know, because that movie was, Last Stand's like a mess. You know, at the end of the, after the credits in The Last Stand, you see a scene with Moira McTaggart, and, you know, she's in a hospital room or something, and then there's a body. And then you hear Charles's voice. So it's like, oh, Charles put his consciousness into that other body. Because actually in The Last Stand, Professor X is teaching a class. And he's talking about how you can take your consciousness and transfer it into another body or something. It actually kind of foreshadows what happens. But then they made up this bullshit. Oh, it was his twin brother who's in a coma or some shit. I don't know. Whatever. So like I'm saying, Professor X technically never died, right? And he's gone through so much in his, you know, if you think about Professor X's history, you know, all the, you know, first class movie, you know, Days of Future Past with Mystique and Magneto and Apocalypse, fighting Apocalypse. He's done so much and he had the school. It's crazy. Professor X led like a super long life and that's how he got taken out. It was really sad by this fucking monster that I wanted him to die. X-24, I wanted that fucking thing to die. And when fucking it got killed at the end, I was like, thank fucking god. But I didn't like, though, that, well, I mean, it's okay, it's not like a huge problem, but I kind of didn't like that X-24 also killed Wolverine. It's like you're gonna have this nameless killing machine kill the two biggest fucking characters in the movie. Like, I don't mind if he kills one, you know. I accepted that he killed Xavier, that makes sense. It makes sense that he killed Wolverine, you know, because it's a fucking unstoppable machine. Nothing else can kill Wolverine except for something like that. Except Wolverine himself, but younger, right? And stronger. So I kind of didn't like that both Xavier and Logan were killed by the same person. But it's not a huge deal. And wow, that... When Logan died, that was crazy, man. I couldn't believe it. You know, I figured it would happen because, you know, I hate that when the trailers give away so much. You know, there's a certain shot in the trailer where he's clutching Laura's hand, and he's like got blood anywhere, everywhere, and you can tell he's like on the ground. And I was like, I'm waiting for that scene to play in the movie. Where the heck is that scene at? And I figured, oh God, that's how he's gonna die, isn't it? And yeah, I was right. Just fucking impaled by a tree stump. Holy shit! Like a thick ass tree stump. Yeah, that was crazy. You know, it really got me when, you know, they're doing the whole, they buried Wolverine and she was talking, and then she turned the grave into an X, you know, for X-Men. I was like, oh man, oh man, that was crazy. Who knows what they're going to do from here? You know, they might make a X-23 movie or something. I don't know how much longer this franchise will go on, this series in particular, before they might reboot it. Technically, it got rebooted with First Class, but they kind of merged it into the, you know, original trilogy. Which I liked, actually. I really liked that. And the fact that Wolverine was in every movie, except for Deadpool, but, you know, Deadpool wore Hugh Jackman's face. Oh, speaking of Deadpool, I'm pretty sure this was at every showing, right? Alright, so you know when the movie's about to start, you know, your theater has a special thing, here's your feature presentation, blah, 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 and then here it comes, ready? And I swear this is the movie starting. I'm like, wait, don't the X-Men movies usually start with the 20th Century Fox, Marvel, and then it goes into the movie, right? No, it started, and it shows this eerie setting. There's guys walking, right? Well, you've seen it, so you know what I'm talking about. Fucking Deadpool. I was like, what the hell is it? Whoa, what's this? Is the movie starting? And then they pan up, it's Deadpool. I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, is Deadpool and Logan? Yeah, right. They're not going to start off this serious-ass movie with fucking Deadpool in the beginning. And no, it was just actually a little short 5-minute clip at the beginning. I was like, oh, that's cool. I like that. I kind of wish Hugh Jackman had a cameo in that, though, because obviously there's not going to be a Deadpool-Wolverine movie. Hugh Jackman could have did a little cameo in that 5-minute clip. Come on, that would have been cool to see them together. But yeah, that was crazy. I was like, yo, a Deadpool freaking short scene? That was awesome. I wonder if they're going to include that on the Blu-ray. I hope they do for Logan. Wow, man, that was hilarious. I was like, they're not fucking starting Logan with Deadpool. What the hell? This is the craziest fucking surprise ever. And yeah, it wasn't the movie. So I was like, oh, okay, that makes sense. It's not the movie. But that was pretty funny. Deadpool got in the phone booth and was changing like really slowly. And then the guy got killed. Man, you saw it. You know what I'm talking about. That was hilarious. I love that. I love that they did that. Man, just... All right, so spoilers. What else can I talk about? I like how they killed... to do with the mechanical hand. All the kids gathered up and freaking all joined together and freaking crushed him. That was epic. I love that. Because, you know, I liked him at first. He had a cool personality. And then you could kind of see going on, like, how much of an asshole he was. So I was like, oh, he needs to die. I wanted X-24 to die the most, and then him, and then the other dude, the business-looking dude. What was his name? Was Price? Xander Price or something? And is he the son of Stryker? Because he said I was the son of... the guy that put the animanium in you. I think he's the son of Stryker then, right? If I'm correct? Because this does take place in 2029, so yeah. If he did have a son, he would be a lot, you know, older. Wait, didn't Stryker have a mutant son, though? Or is this another son? I don't know. I don't even know if it's Stryker's son, this guy. I'm gonna look it up later. Anyways, he was kind of bland for me. Like I said earlier, he was the bland villain. He didn't really do much for me. I like that Wolverine just shot him. He's like, you're dead. Bye-bye. That kind of surprised me. It just came out of nowhere. I was like, oh, okay. But the other villain was better. You know, X-24, like I said, fucking unstoppable killing machine. Holy shit. But yeah, just great movie, man. and I want to talk about the Professor X stuff with his, you know, seizures, you know, everything's going. I actually really enjoyed that. I was thinking when I watched the trailer for the first time, I'm like, what the hell is this going on where everything's all shaky? I'm like, wait a minute, is this going to be happening a lot in the movie, and is it going to look good? I was worried. I was like, oh no, is this going to be really bad? But no, when you see the movie, it happens like what, 2 or 3 times? It's freaking incredible, especially the part when they're in the hotel or the casino, whatever that was, right? That sequence was freaking awesome. It's kind of like Quicksilver, you know what I mean? Where everyone's like frozen and he's walking around. But except, you know, Wolverine struggling to actually move. But yeah, and they definitely utilized the old man Logan. He's an old man. He can't heal. They definitely utilized that very well. He's a lot weaker now. You know, fucking against X-24, he got his ass kicked. But Still, Wolverine's still a badass, though. He was slicing up dudes right at the beginning of the movie and throughout, and... Oh, man. Oh, wait, I just thought of something that I didn't talk about. Wait, what was it? Shit, I just lost it. Damn it! I just remembered something that I don't think I talked about yet. Fuck. I just saw the movie, man. I can't think of everything. Damn it. What was it? I literally just had the thought in my mind. Fuck, I'll think of something else to talk about. X-23, Laura, like I said, great character. It was funny when she first talked. I was like, oh, she actually does talk. I figured she would talk eventually. You're not going to have her slamming throughout the whole movie. You know what I think what I thought was going to happen? She was going to be silent throughout the whole movie. And I was thinking, if Wolverine dies at the end and she's clutching his hand like I saw in the trailer, if that's his death scene, maybe she's going to say her first word in the movie and she's going to say, Logan. And, you know, when he dies. I thought that would be, like, perfect. After what I saw at the movie, I was like, never mind. What they did was better. They actually had her talk and interact with him and stuff. You know what I mean? So that was a lot better than what, you know, I imagined. But Professor X is funny as hell, man. He was cursing up a storm in this movie. You know, like I said, sad to see him die. Figured it would happen, but man, that was really sad. You know, and then that whole family got killed too. I was like, oh my god, that's crazy. Freaking that mom got destroyed. The main guy, the dad, he got killed too. He just fell down after he shot X-24 in the face. I thought that killed X-24, but no, it didn't. You know, even the son got killed too. That was fucking brutal. Holy shit. Man, this movie was brutal as hell. Now I'm thinking back at it, like, crazy. Damn, what else? The Caliban character was interesting. You know, he was in the X-Men Apocalypse movie. He didn't have much of a role. He was with, what's her name? Psylocke, when she first met Apocalypse, if you remember. I guess you could say he's different in this movie. I mean, it takes, like, what, 40 years plus after Apocalypse? And yeah, he can't go out in the sun. He gets burnt up. But he was an interesting character. He was funny for the little we had him in there. I just remembered. This, I don't know if this is what I was thinking of that I forgot. But all the mutants are gone, apparently. So I guess, you know, because they're living out in Texas now. Charles is a lot older. This only takes six years after End of Days of Future Past. You know, when Wolverine gets his, you know, comes back and he sees Jean Grey and he sees Cyclops and all that. That very happy, beautiful ending. This only takes place 6 years after that. And I guess the school's gone. Most of the mutants are dead. I don't know. Like, everything just went to shit. Like, in 6 years. I know this is supposed to be, like, its own thing. You know, I mean, it does take place after that. But I know this is supposed to be its own thing. So they don't really have to follow up on that. But I just thought it was crazy how in 6 years, just everything went to shit for them. So I guess Magneto's dead. I guess everybody's dead, right? I don't know. It's just crazy. They didn't really elaborate on that, so who knows? Maybe we might get some more movies with them if they're still alive, any of those characters. What else can I freaking talk about, man? I knew I had more. Shit, I don't know what else to freaking talk about. Ah, come on, there's gotta be something else in there, man. I think I might have covered every single fucking thing in this movie. Let me say, the part that I thought was a little bit slow, when Wolverine gets to the, what's it called, the Eden place, where all the kids are, you know, for the first time, and they lift him up there with that stretcher he was on, I guess you could call it, that scene with him there kind of dragged on a little bit, because he kept waking up, you know, falling asleep, waking up, falling asleep. I understand, though, it's realistic, because, you know, he is old, and he's been doing all this shit for the past few days, nonstop killing people, getting shot, all this shit. So he did have to rest a couple of days. I understand that. They said he was in bed for like 2 days straight or something. But I felt like that kind of dragged on just a slight bit. That and then the fact that the other villain, the dude with the glasses, the business-looking dude, Xander or whatever his name is, he was kind of bland for me. He didn't do much. So those are the only two like nitpicks with the movie. Other than that, I'm giving this 10 out of 10. Fantastic. So what? It's March right now. So usually movies come on Blu-ray 3 months after release, maybe 4 months. So June, July-ish, I cannot wait to pre-order this damn movie and watch it a million times. And I hope to God that Deadpool scene is in the Blu-ray. So yeah. Let me know what you guys think of this movie. Yeah, man. Just let me know what you guys think of this. You know, and if you're going to say something that's a spoiler, you know, begin your comment with spoilers in all caps. With little, you know, stars on the top. You know, those little star things? Star, spoilers, star, whatever that thing's called. It's like a 8-pointed star or some shit. Whatever it is, you know what I mean. But yeah, if you want to talk spoilers, make sure you say spoilers in your comment. Like, say spoilers before you say anything. So people don't, you know, look at it accidentally and get their movie ruined. I did not want to know anything going on. Like, I watched the trailers and I seen TV spots, but I avoided any spoilers. I did not want to look at a plot synopsis or any bullshit. I do need to talk about no scene after the credits. You know what? That's fine with me, actually, because the way this movie ended, you don't need another thing. You don't need another thing at the end to tag another movie. You don't need some bullshit where Wolverine's actually alive. He sticks his hand out of the ground. I'm alive! Like, you know, Batman v Superman, where Superman was alive at the end. And they didn't even do that in the credits. They literally did it at the end of the movie when they've been mourning him. And then all of a sudden, oh, he's alive. Yeah, I know some people in my theater were disappointed, though. Like, everyone was sitting... I sat there, because... You never know. There might be a scene after credits. Even after a perfect ending like that, there could be a scene after the credits. So everybody sat there. Some people left. But yeah, and then there was no scene. And people were like, really? We sat here for 6 minutes. I heard a guy say, I've been sitting here for 6 minutes and there's no scene. I mean, it's not a huge deal. Whatever. But yeah, man. Just... Man. Freaking masterpiece, honestly. Yeah, this is 10 out of 10. All right, I've been rambling for 27 minutes. Holy crap, I didn't know I've been talking this long. If you guys sat through this whole video, you're awesome. Like I said, talk about the movie with me. How'd you like it? Did you like it? Blah, blah, blah. Just great. So, thank you guys for watching this. I'm going to go home, shoot a couple of videos, actually. I'm going to upload this, obviously. I want to watch it again, like, right now. But I have to wait. I might go see it with some friends, actually, from work tomorrow. Because they really want to see it. Freaking no one is able to go see it with me tonight. So I went by myself. It's not a huge deal. I can actually appreciate the movie more when I'm by myself, actually. I know it's kind of weird to go to theater by yourself. But, well, it's not weird. I'm sure all the movie reviewers do it, right? They don't always have someone to go with them, do they? It's kind of better, though. Because, like I said, you can absorb it all. You don't have somebody distracting you, like your friend's like on his phone and like you're looking over like, really? You're on your phone right now during this awesome fucking movie? Like, really? And it takes your mind away from the movie. You know, I put my phone on Do Not Disturb. You know, I have it on silent. You know, I almost want to turn it off, but you know, there might be an emergency or something. You never know. Yeah, just 10 out of 10. I'm going to stop rambling because this video is going on way too long. Go see it. I mean, if you're at this part of the video, you've seen it. So, yes, go see it again, because I will. All right. Thank you guys for watching. You're awesome for sitting through this whole thing. I love you. I'm going to go home and do some stuff. All right. That was Logan. That was amazing. All right. Goodbye.